This deck has it all. Block, exhaust, block, health, block. Greetings. Choose. Hmm. 99 gold removed too. Always kind of interesting. I tend to find that I'm looking to snowball as early as possible on Ironclad. Which is to say, I want to start building power, collecting relics in large quantity, and getting ahead, essentially, at every opportunity. Doesn't seem like this act allows for a whole lot of that. There's not an abundance of elites or anything. And so I think that we may want to be a bit more ambitious with our starting bonus. Actually, looking at the path here now, I think I like this one, especially if I go with remove two. Taking five combats would allow us to add a bunch of cards to replace the removed cards, and then we should be in a good position to fight a Burning Elite with an upgrade or a rest beforehand. And then we should definitely grab this late elite here as well. I guess there technically is a three elite path, now that I look at it. We could go one, two, three. That would mean no upgrade for the first two elites, which is a little iffy, but not impossible. Anyway, I think what I've decided is removing two cards here. Going into Slime Boss, I did wonder if we should maybe remove one Strike and one Defend. I'm often a little hesitant to remove Defends on Ironclad because you already have a preponderance of damage in the starting deck and an additional preponderance of damage in the Ironclad card pool means that you're likely to lean attack heavy. Additionally, the Corruption card makes all your skills exhaust, and you definitely want to have all four defends if a Corruption is picked up. But I think I will do one in one here. Yeah, Curious Observer, I'm feeling a lot better. Life's good today. Strike twice here, block once. Seems like the real option here. We could do something weird like Bash Strike the Acid Slime. Try to kill it next turn, but no. Surely we kill the front slime first in this fight. There's no way taking 14 would ever be correct. It's at least something worth considering, though. Simply blocking all of the damage available to you on every single turn in Slay the Spire is not going to win you fights all that often, actually. Spire requires you to make calculated trades of health for progress in fights, and if you fail to do that, you will fall behind and you will lose. But being able to end the fight decisively by killing your foes quickly, that gets you ahead in Slay the Spire. Hey Kleiny, is it weird that my YouTube videos help you go to sleep? Not at all. I consider it a compliment when people say this about my content. I, for myself, used the content of other streams and YouTube creators to fall asleep to for years, although I no longer do so. And I really, really, really enjoyed at the time the wide breadth of content and immense backlogs and archives that they had available to watch and fall asleep to. It was really good stuff. Plus, from an analytics perspective, people who fall asleep watching the stream are yeah, good. Thank you. You tune in and you stay tuned in, and that makes the analytics happy. So, shout out to anybody who falls asleep watching the stream. You're doing the good stuff. Nitrous Oxide says, I've grown to remove two defends from Ironclad nowadays. What do I think? Definitely wouldn't do that against Guardian at a minimum. Find that would potentially be problematic in the later game. I guess my question back to you would be, do you do heart runs and what Ascension do you play at? The lower the Ascension, the more reasonable that is. For example, on Ascension 0 or Ascension 1, remove 2 defends every time. Go full smoke strats. It's really, really good. But the higher up the Ascension climb you go, the more it becomes a tricky decision. Hemokinemo. Let's take it. I definitely like taking Hemokinesis here over Heavy Blade, by the way. Hemokinesis offers very efficient, powerful damage in the early game, especially with an upgrade. The lose two health part is a little daunting, but relating to what I said in the first combat here, there's a lot of value in just making some calculated trades. Lose a little bit of health in a deliberate fashion to make progress in a fight. And a card like Hemokinesis here, for example, allows us to one-shot this louse. Although I think we actually just want to go Defend Strike here, take one rather than two. That's the other strength of a card like Hemokinesis. You as a player have the discretion to either play it or not play it. If it's not favorable, don't play it. Pommel Strike's pretty good. I also do wonder maybe if we should take a Shrug It Off, having removed our one defend. Both of these are excellent early game commons for Clad. They have higher base value than a Defender Strike, and that built-in draw one means that they're very good in the late game as you get more energy. BE, thanks for the 2 full years of support. Boomerang Cross Enjoyer says, the last 2 nights I woke up at 3 a.m. to me explaining why taking Runic Pyramid over Calling Bell. Good stuff. Good stuff. Let's do a Shrug here. So again, taking the damage in a deliberate fashion here, I do think that in this fight, playing Hemokinesis will save us more health in the long run than the 2 damage we take. Normally in the Ironclad versus Cultist matchup, you have to take 6 damage, approximately, to win. Because you have to, you can, under an ideal draw, you play Bash Strike turn 1, Strike, Defend turn 2, and then you generally don't have quite enough damage to kill turn 3, so you have to miss out on a defend somewhere to make up the difference. But if we play Hemokinesis, pretty much guaranteed to win with taking very little damage here. In fact, we draw 3 strikes, which we do. We just kill outright. So we healed more than we took there. That's pretty excellent. Whirlwind, Ghostly Armor, Second Wind. Actually, don't think of very highly of Whirlwind prior to obtaining an upgrade on it. Does very much want an upgrade to be able to hit for pretty good damage multiple times to all enemies. Whirlwind is exceptional if you can add some energy generation or some strength to it as well. Given that we're fighting Slime Boss later in the act, I do think there's a lot of value to taking an area damage card. So I'm probably going to grab this Whirlwind. Let's do it. Also gives us some multi-enemy answers in the next 2 fights. Having gone through 3 so-called easy pool fights here, our next 2 fights are more difficult and can include things like gremlins or lice. And the Whirlwind can be an easy answer to those. Normally this fellow is a pretty easy fight. I'm staring at a lot of damage turn 1 here, though. I'm going to take 13 no matter what, because we cannot kill with this hand, and I drew no block whatsoever. Might be tempted to smoke bomb here to get out of the fight. We would heal to full in that case, but if we do that, we're missing out on the valuable card reward from this fight. And the whole point of taking these combats here is to get card rewards to enable us to defeat the Burning Elite. I don't think, when it comes to that Burning Elite, I don't think about 10 health is going to make as much of a difference as an extra card reward will. And indeed, even if the Fire Potion would let us get a kill, I don't think I would. Yeah, we're 1 short of a kill with Fire Potion. I think I'd still prefer to... We will play Hemo, by the way. We're just going to take the 15, since we get to heal 6 of it back anyway, and decisively win this fight. Get 17 gold and Dark Embrace, Thunderclap, or Heavy Blade. I'm definitely a firm believer in Dark Embrace as an Ironclad game breaker of sorts. It's got incredible utility if we encounter the Sentry's Elite. Pretty good against the Slime Boss, too. I think I should take it. Ian Cavalier says, why is Smoke Bomb a consideration but not the Fire Potion? when I've got potions in Slay the Spire, I tend to have a specific use case for them in mind, or a specific purpose. In the early game, any potion that does damage, especially the fire potion, is to be used on elites to get through the most dangerous early game damage checks in order to get rewards and start progressing through the rest of the game. This fire potion is our ticket to the burning elite being a successful combat for us, and so I value this fire potion at probably around 32 health, one turn of Gremlin Knob smashing you in the face, or maybe 24 health if we play no skills whatsoever. So for anything less than 24 health, I will not trade this fire potion. Is Dark Embrace ever a bad idea in Act 1? Definitely. Definitely. It's a big two-cost power. Drawing this instead of a striker defend can really bite you in the butt. For example, if we go to the next floor and there's four gremlins and we draw a Dark Embrace turn 1, we're going to be really sad about it. But we still have a smoke bomb, so it's pretty hard for something to go that badly. I'm going to take this. It's just one thief. Well, he doesn't seem that threatening. We would like to KO this fool, even if we take some damage for it. Again, we could smoke bomb here to escape this fight, heal 6, and simply proceed to the elite. But we'd rather get some more money, get another card reward, ideally a strength gain card of some kind, but I'll take what I have offered. Carnage would be good as well. Uppercut would be good. There's quite a few cards I'd like to add. Let's go defend Hemo here. Just too much damage to ignore most of the time. And then defend Bash this turn. We take 6. We should be able to KO next turn. Yes. Okay. So our health stays relatively high. We do not find another potion. We do find Iron Wave, Twin Strike, Whirlwind. These aren't very good. Twin Strike is okay. Don't know if it's good enough to add. I'm wondering if we actually upgrade Hemokinesis going into the elite fight here as well. Yeah, it's kind of an twin strike with no strength. We already have cards that really want some strength, so this is going to reward us if we do eventually find the strength. We could go double Whirlwind. I don't think that's necessarily a good idea, but it is funny. And if we were to find a Chemex, it'd be amazing, but we have no assurance of that at all. Dueling Saiyan says, what are we missing for the Mastery Challenge on Ironclad? Just the Relic Champ Spell at the moment. That's it. I think in terms of what gets us through this Burning Elite, the Twin Strike does help a bit here. We're not that good. Especially if we roll Max HP, Legavulin, or Gremlin Knob, we could have a big problem. For those fights, upgrading Bash might be worth it. Although you don't want upgraded Bash versus Legavulin, because of... Yeah. Alright, let's take the Twin Strike, and I think I upgrade Hemokinesis for +5 here. Normally, I would advocate for Whirlwind upgrade. It's the most important upgrade versus Sentries, typically, but with Dark Embrace in the deck, I don't think we need to upgrade the Whirlwind. It's also just about killing one of them as quickly as possible, and the Hemokinesis plus the Fire Potion will do that quite easily. So, yeah, let's upgrade the Hemokinesis first, Whirlwind second, and see who we're fighting here. It is Max Health Legavulin. Spooky. That is terrifying. Maybe so terrifying that we might want to think about Smoke Bomb, depending on the draw order here. Hopefully we can play the Dark Embrace with no consequence. We can, and then we can make up with Bash. Okay, that's pretty good. I'm pretty happy with this. But this is definitely a nightmare scenario for this elite, and we're extremely glad for the upgrade on Hemokinesis as well as the Twin Strike pick going into this fight here. Next turn looks a little disappointing, but Bash Hemo, that's not disappointing at all. Take 30. I think we absolutely play these strikes for 9 damage. We are not going to get a lot of opportunities to deal damage in this fight. We need to take every single one that we get. for the most part. Bash Hemo again? Just Hemo. Concerning. And Shrug doesn't seem helpful. We should have just smoke bombed. It's gonna do 25 more damage. Hemokinesis will do all the damage we need. Looks like we're gonna be resting at that next fire. I think that means we can play defend. What are all the draw possibilities? If we draw strike, twin strike, shrug, defend, defend. Or really anything that doesn't involve hemokinesis. Can we win? Let's see. With minus 2 strength, this will do 6. This will do 3, 4 times 2. And this will do 4 times 1. So 6 plus 8 plus 4 is the best we can do without hemokinesis. It's 18. So that's one short. Even if I play the strike, that's one short. Whereas if we do draw hemokinesis, we're always there. So I think there's no reason not to play the defend, is what I'm seeing here. Either we draw the hemokinesis and we get there, or we don't and we don't get there. It doesn't matter if I play a strike or not here. We draw the hemokinesis, and we get there. And that was accounting for with the fire potion, by the way. There's no point in using it prematurely, but yeah, the whole time we were considering that fire potion to be in effect. I didn't really make that explicit. Well, we lost a lot of our health, but we get a prayer wheel, and that is a very powerful reward this early in a run. This is why it's worth risking one's life sometimes. We also get offered a Fiend Fire, a very powerful card, dealing damage based on the number of cards in hand. Yeah, and we've got a Dark Embrace. Uh-oh. Alright, well maybe this is what the smoke bomb is for. Anger the Mushrooms. This is a very dangerous fight on floor 8. Due to your lack of specialization in mycology, you are unable to identify the specimens. And so, stumble upon them. Fight definitely requires some good damage output to be able to win. We have that somewhat with hemokinesis here. And I see that I could use Fiendfire to kill one of them on turn one here, taking only one damage. There might be a chance we can win this, especially if the back one buffs next turn and we can kill the front one with hemokinesis. So I'm not yet willing to flee with smoke bomb. I'm willing to risk one health to look at the next turn before we leave here. Become vulnerable upon killing one. That's what makes the fight against three of them so challenging. Once you kill the first one, you're now vulnerable and there's two of them staring you down. We do not draw well enough to survive the fight, so we have to leave. We get 6 health back, so we end up at 19 HP. We don't get the odd mushroom relic or a card reward, but we leave with our life. And that'll do. That will do. Lurking Fool, did you hear about the mushroom who is always getting invited to parties? They say he's a fun guy. Gremlin Horn, where were you last floor? When an enemy dies, gain an energy and draw a card. That's going to help out a lot in the slime boss fight when we get there. And although what just happened looks a little bleak and we're pretty badly damaged, I would not get too discouraged in a situation like this. Now that we have some pretty decent added cards and a couple of relics supporting us, our health can trend upwards in combats rather than downwards for the most part. Although we may still want to have a schnooze. Let's get to that rest site. Oh. Oh-ho. You come across a group of what look like purple fire spirits dancing around a large bonfire. The spirits toss small bones and fragments into the fire, which brilliantly erupt each time. As you approach, the spirits all turn to you expectantly. We offer a card from our deck, and we receive a reward based on the rarity of that card. Offer a starter card like our Strike or Defend, we get nothing. We just remove the card. And that in itself is a good thing. Remove a common card like Shrug It Off, you get 5 hit point healing, and the card is removed. Remove an uncommon card with a blue sash like Whirlwind or Dark Embrace, you get a full heal, all the way up to 75 hit points. And if we remove a rare card like Fiend Fire with a gold sash, we get a heal to full and 10 additional max HP for the rest of the run. So we get the largest reward here from sacrificing Fiendfire, but we could also lose one of our uncommons. I would nominate either Dark Embrace or Whirlwind for the full heal. I don't think I would lose Dark Embrace. We could also lose Hemokinesis if only I had chosen not to upgrade it. We need Whirlwind a lot less now that we have Gremlin Horn. Food for thought. But I'm also deeply tempted to lose the Fiendfire for the 10 max HP. That said, Fiendfire with Dark Embrace is very strong. Being upgraded or not has no impact on what we get as a reward from this. So we'd ideally prefer to sacrifice an unupgraded card. What if you sacrifice a curse? You get a special relic called the Spirit Poop, which does nothing, but it's there. Alright, we'll lose this Whirlwind. I don't need it for the Sentries fight, and I don't think I need it for Slime Boss either. I guess that means we upgrade Fiendfire instead. Seems good to me. Let's do it. Oh no! Where's my Whirlwind now? How will I ever get through this fight without the aid of Whirlwind? Oh right, by drawing cards and getting free energy all the time, that's how. Thanks, Gremlin Horn. That's how. And we're guaranteed to draw a Twin Strike, yes? So let's do Strike here, Fiendfire here. Twin Strike here. Defend. Again, what do I need the Whirlwind for, is my question. No one is as powerful as the man with two smoke bombs. Wait, what? Hey! That's cheating, game. You're supposed to offer me different cards. That said, I do think we might want to consider an evolve here. Because this deck is already set up to delete half of itself. We're very vulnerable to enemies that add status cards. Also, the more cards I have in hand, the more powerful this Fiendfire is. And because we have Prayer Wheel, it should be easier to find cards that add status cards, particularly Power Through, which I'd love to be able to add with an Evolve. Most importantly, the Evolve helps with the Slime Boss fight. Let's take an Evolve here. Do I want Sword Boomerang, Rage, or Hemokinesis? Not really. No, not really. Okay. Next fight. Spooky. Hmm. If I Hemokinesis Fiend Fire, I can do 50 damage. I could also just Fiend Fire right away, kill the Spike Slime, and draw one. Then we're fighting Cultists one turn behind. That's not a big deal with the current deck. Next turn, the slime is going to bop us. I guess that's not the biggest of deals. Let's do it this way. Take the cultist out first. Yeah, that's not a big deal. No problem. We have no... Well, you're going to add one or two slime, right? Give me an evolve in play, sure. And now we don't need to play Hemo, although we're only missing 3 health, so we might as well, actually. Because we'll heal to full from the Burning Blood. Back to full. Feel no pain. With Fiend Fire Dark Embrace evolve. True Grit also an option. I'm going to click the Feel No Pain, I think. We've already got pretty good reasons to do so. And again, the cards added by the Slime Boss are going to exhaust as well. Do I want to cleave, intimidate, or clash? Not really. We want to intimidate as well. With Dark Embrace, it's not bad, that's for sure. I don't think I want to add this one. A little bit too much of a do-nothing card at the moment. And because the Spire is merciful, these are the elites we face. No Gremlin Knob, just the elite that we have 3 powers for. Should be easy peasy. Do I want to bother to try to Hemo? I don't think so. I think I'm going to just Dark Embrace block turn one like a chump. Set ourselves up for success here. This turn hurts a bit more. But then we're in the clear. Let's see. We could have done another 16. So I would have had to do Defend, Strike, Hemo this turn. I don't know if that would have been enough to be correct. We'll see. Just Smoke Bomb. No way. Now, we have more than enough hit points for both this fight and the Slime Boss fight, as things stand. Why would I ever Smoke Bomb here? I'm invincible now. Actually, we have a problem, which is that the enemies are not adding enough dazed. Need more. More, I tell you. Yeah, where's Fire Breathing? I would be okay with Fire Breathing. We have a higher chance of finding it thanks to Prayer Wheel. We also get an Ink Bottle, Juggernaut, or Return the Whirlwind to the deck. Juggernaut, Feel No Pain, Dark Embrace. Kind of cool, actually. It's a lot of powers, but it's the right kind of powers. So each daze drew us 2 cards and gave us 3 armor. That's right, Zoomwaffle. That's exactly right. Any plans to stream Civ 6 again? Not this weekend, but I could definitely see us returning to Civ in the future. Trying out the Immortal difficulty. But no, I don't have any discrete, like, I'll play it on this date plans at the moment. I'm going to take that Juggernaut. I have no idea if it's going to lead to success, but it sure sounds fun. Let's upgrade it, question mark? Might also want to upgrade Dark Embrace here. I think the Evolve upgrade would be overkill at the moment. I'm going to upgrade the Juggernaut. And we're going to see how this goes. Tisk tisk. surely I don't need to use a potion in this fight, right? There's no way. Next turn could hurt, but even if we have to take a slime crush, we'll be fine. If he can fire these three cards, I don't think so. More likely Hemokinesis and Strike. Prayer Wheel just failed to trigger. We were fighting an elite. And it only gives bonus rewards during non-elite combats. Yeah, that's definitely a slime crush we gotta take to the face. No biggie, don't worry about it. That's what the full heal was for, after all. Give me more slime. They only make me stronger. Get him, Juggernaut. GG. Well, there's the I mean, now we're already at the point where that defend that we removed at the start of the game now feels pretty bad. Here's Corruption to do the full Exodia thing, so to speak. Put all the powers in play, and then all of our skills will draw us cards, give us extra block, and then deal damage two times. The only problem is there's actually not very many skills in this deck. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. But also Prayer Wheel, so it's going to be easy to find new cards to make this work with. Definitely. Definitely take the Corruption here. I think you'd be crazy not to. Put all the powers together into a giant pot. The only question before me is, do we Pandora's Box or Astrolabe? I'm thinking we want to Astrolabe three strikes here. Get three random upgraded cards. I'm hoping Juggernaut, Feel No Pain, Dark Embrace, personally, but who knows what we'll get. What we don't want is Velvet Choker, limiting our card plays per turn. When you're trying to combo powers like this, there's no success to be found with limited card plays. You want to be able to play the whole deck all at once. So it's either transform seven cards or transform just three, but also upgrade them. And we get to choose which three. I'd really rather keep the defense, considering the Corruption, Dark Embrace, Feel No Pain thing. So let's just lose three strikes, turn them into Fiend, Fire, Immolate, and Feed. Seems pretty good. Three yellow cards. It's actually not that unlikely. Maybe a 1 in 9 or so. No, 1 in 27. Excuse me. 1 in 27 or so. Why do we leave Bash? Well, it's our only source of vulnerable. It is a bit difficult to play, admittedly. But Vuln is good. Definitely going to be difficult to land this feed, that's for dang sure. So, now that we have both a feed and a prayer wheel, I think it behooves us to avoid elite combats and just take regular combats, which are more valuable than event nodes or elites for the most part, because of the additional card, which is a chance to be upgraded, and the potential for additional max health. So I'm thinking we take a path something like this. Totally different than our usual route finding here. Normally I'd be all about elite hunting in Act 2, especially with Gremlin Horn, which makes it a lot easier. But because our reward incentives have been flipped around a bit, things are a little different. Do not put me on pizza says both classes are roughly 1-to-2-to-1 ratio of common to uncommon to rare cards. That's right. So a transform has about a 25% chance to be common, 50% chance-ish to be uncommon, 25% chance-ish to be rare. It's a bit different depending on the character. Closer to 4-7-4 says real evab. That feels closer to correct. It's out of 75 total. So uncommon is the most common. For transforms, yes. Uncommon is the most numerous. How's it going? Kaya is a bean. Kaya asking, do we master a card by having it in our deck when we win on A20? Yes, that's the fundamental challenge, but because I'm real spicy-like, we need to do it with two of them. Not just one, but two. That includes curses and unique cards that you can only normally get one of, which we've had to resort to nefarious tactics to get the second copy. Believe it or not, we've already accomplished this with Ritual Dagger, Jax, and Curse of the Bell. But there's a few other unique cards to do still, notably the Necronomicurse. Oh, this is two shops, huh? Currently, we're very short on energy. We have a problem, which is that we're going to die. Oh, actually, this doesn't seem that bad, unless I remove all of my damage. No, we do not. I'll take it. Yeah, but then turns like this happen, right? Spooky. Interesting. The Juggernaut damage happened after this enemy's block wore off. Curious. I'll be back for you. Note our precipitous lack of health suddenly. We get back 10 at the end there. 4 max health and a heal of 6 from the Burning Blood. That's going to have to sustain us. I think our immediate short-term goal is to add more skills to the deck. Warcry Plus and Shrug are both particularly welcome here. Don't think we want a Boomerang Plus with no strength. And we want to keep taking fights because, well, they're good for us. If we can win them. Which we can sometimes do. Let's see here. Fiendfire would do 60 damage. That is not enough. What if I Strength Potion? It would do 72 damage. He does not kill still. So we're probably going to Fiendfire into playing Shrug It Off. And then try to kill with something like Immolate Feed. Good luck to us. This is every card in my deck currently. They're all in my hand. Hopefully we draw both Immolate and Feed. Otherwise, you might have a problem. Oh, good. That worked out nicely. So I think we actually gained health from that fight. That's good. Oh, here we go. Okay. I was just thinking, this deck is doing okay at the moment, but what it really needs is a sudden burst of energy to really allow us to play more powers in one turn, or to play powers and also block or attack. Bloodletting with a free upgrade is ginormously good here, allowing us to trade some of our hit points, which we can get in spades at the moment, for tons of energy. We want an anger or an uppercut. Body slam could be good, although it does require an upgrade. I think at the moment the Juggernaut is doing most of the damage. We shouldn't need a body slam. Who's our act boss? Bronze Automaton. We shouldn't need a body slam. I don't think. I take Distilled Chaos over this Strength Potion. Although, Distilled Chaos is maybe a little bit unpredictable. Choices. Meat on the bone, barely within our price range. Very nice, considering the abundance of health loss. I'm So Cody. Thanks for the 18 months. Twitch baby number two. Sibling get. Would cost us basically all our money to get the meat on the bone, but it is a nice way to sustain ourselves through many, many combats, which is the current plan, actually. This would be really good in Act 3 as well. Yeah, True Grit Karga move is nice and cheap. True Grit also wants an upgrade, but he is very nice in a deck like this. Secret Technique is interesting as well. Although, what does Secret Technique actually fetch? It fetches the freaking Bloodletting, is what it does. Actually, that's pretty good. Give me that. Oh, and I can afford True Grit Remove on top? That's probably going to happen. Now that I have Bloodletting, the Bash is actually quite good. So let's remove the Last Strike. And buy the True Grit. You heard me, the Last Strike is gone. Oh no. Well, guess what? I found a use for the Distilled Chaos. It's getting me out of whatever the heck this is. Maybe. Or playing Fiendfire and destroying everything. Also, maybe. Probably should play Immolate first. Just in case. Or we could do Juggernaut first. That's more likely to be better. Yeah, we're probably going to play at least enough block to make this do more damage than Immolate. Sure. Yep. Thought we were going to Fiendfire. Hey, we blocked for 10, though. And Feed is gone, so we might as well just finish the job now. Just going to set up the Ink Bottle for the next fight here. Distilled Chaos returns to us. Pummel is here. Battle Trance is here. Although Battle Trance can cut our drawing short from the Dark Embrace and such, I really, really like it still. Double Tap with Fiendfire is actually quite dangerous in this deck. Could result in deleting all of our cards by accident. See exclamation point empty for an example. Evolve plus Chosen One. Excellent. Let's see, how does this work? I'm going to redraw this card, aren't I? Okay, noted. That doesn't work the way you want it to. Duly noted. So go Evolve. Twin Strike True Grit? Question mark? Or maybe Hemo True Grit? I think this bird is an... Well, we'd like to get the bird into a feed range, actually. This will do 14 to them. This does 10. Let's do Hemokinesis True Grit. Want a corruption, then shrug it off. And then Secret Tech Bloodletting? Or just Secret Tech Shrug? Let's just Secret Tech the other Shrug. Okay, there's Feed, unfortunately. That's fine. We're going to draw a lot of cards in a moment, though. Although, none of them are going to yield block yet, because we didn't play the Field of Pain. Don't actually think that's an issue. bye-bye now. Delicious. And now there's no days in the deck left either. You got rid of all of them. Beautiful stuff. Pummel with a plus on it this time. And another Warcry plus. Get in here. Do I take that pummel with a plus on it? It's not that good. It only really does 10 damage. Have I ever played Spore? Yes. I have the distinct memory of playing Spore on the day it launched. To my own profound disappointment. This brigand says, how many hours do I think it took before I had a decent understanding of A20? I want to say at least 2,000. That's 2,000 hours of playing at A20 as well. So maybe like 3,000 to 4,000 total hours of play. That was after Black and White. That's right, Goon the Spoon. Yes. Yes. Yeah, exactly. Like a much earlier version of No Man's Sky. A good lesson in setting expectations when it comes to media content that's up and coming in general. So Spore is one of the many reasons that I don't talk about or focus too much on the games that are going to come out in the future, because the things that say about the people that... let me rephrase that. The things that people say about the games that are going to come out and what the games are actually like don't necessarily have any relation to one another. So I prefer the wait-and-see approach. The Plebiscite, thanks for the 5 months. Happy slaying to you. Agreed, Annabelle. No Man's Sky is really cool in particular because there's a game that ended up setting expectations higher than it could possibly fulfill. Managed to meet immense success because of those immense public expectations, despite not actually meeting them, but then realized that they should do something to rectify the situation and actually improve the game to the point where now No Man's Sky is genuinely good, even if it doesn't have all of the things that were, you know, storyboarded or idealized for the game, because some of them are not realistic to implement whatsoever. It's still a game that's well above and beyond the original launch product in so many ways. Will I be playing anything in the Steam Next Fest? No. I will not be. Pummel's almost okay with a strength potion. I think I'm just going to keep the current potions and not take this pummel. What? Clothesline. Am I worried about being able to deal damage? Not really, actually. I think I'm fine. What I am worried about is being able to afford all my cards. So let's get energy reduction upgrades. These are some of the most important in a deck like this. We want to upgrade the Corruption. We want to upgrade the Dark Embrace so that they cost 2 and 1, respectively. And again, not going for this elite on purpose, because I'd rather take the combat and get the Dark Embrace upgraded before we brave elite combats here. Sneko should be manageable, although this is a questionable starting draw here. Well, that's pretty good. Ho ho! Nice. Thanks for the free cards, Sneko. Note that I put the Fiendfire back on top of the deck because it cost 3 with the Warcry and then redrew it with the Dark Embrace. It re-randomized because the confusion effect here changes the cost of the card each time it's drawn. So if we draw the Fiendfire 2 times, we get to randomize the cost 2 times. Now it's free. Easy. Who needs meat on the bone? Intimidate looking a little bit better. Shockwave. Definitely a corruption card. Second bloodletting is not bad. Armaments is not bad. But let's take a shockwave for sure. How do we feel about... We already have True Grit, right? We paid for it. Do I take another unupgraded True Grit? Probably not. No, I don't. Can I have my 25 gold back? No? All right. That's fine. Okay, now our cards are affordable. And we get a relic of relatively high rarity. Dead Branch incoming, says Rakbar. White Bee Statue incoming. Guaranteed potions. And a ton of cash, which will help a lot because we have to go to the shop. Cool. The three Slavermans are here. But we need not fear, because we are armed with potions galore. Let's see, we can secret tech for any skill in the deck. Can actually get a lot done by simply doing secret tech for Battle Trance, Fiendfire, and Shrug. You're Clyde, and thanks for the 9 months in the Prime sub. And Noxfrags in chat asks, just wondering, what's my position on using Save and Quit to reset combats, or so-called save scumming, as it's referred to in some games, some game communities. I don't think there's anything scummy about it. This is a single-player game, so you can play it how you want. That includes using custom mode modifiers to make the game easier or harder, using mods to make the game easier or harder. It's all about creating an experience that's interesting for you. I think using Save and Quit to redo combats can teach you about when it can be correct to do certain unusual things in Slay the Spire. It's not always immediately obvious how you should play the cards in your hand in a combat of Slay the Spire. But sort of going back and retrying can give you a way to sort of learn that. At the same time, because you're going to re-experience the same random draws and enemy attacks, you're also getting into some results-based thinking, potentially, if you do this too much. And this can lead you away from the correct way to navigate combats, because you're no longer worried about... you lose sight of what is the statistically correct play to make, and focus on what was the correct outcome for this random assignment, and this random assignment only. I don't do it on stream because I think that using Save and Quit in any fashion goes against the spirit of the roguelike genre, which is that you live or die by the choices and mistakes that you make. But there's definitely a time or place for it. We've used Save and Quit to retry or explore certain fights before in the past. And I've done it occasionally off-stream, too, to explore a little bit. Learning when to play Corruption and Bias Cog can be one of the hardest things. Before we got into that, I probably should have done the dad joke first. A dad joke for Cry of the Wind. How does the Ironclad make new social connections? He uses his friend fire. That's what I got for you. Sometimes the statistically best option is incorrect. That's right, just as it is in poker, right? If you've got pocket aces, it's almost always correct to raise the stakes or go all in or whatever. But then if your opponent pulls a straight flush, you can be ousted because they had the unlikely but better outcome. So what are we searching for here? I do think we want to start with Shrug. I was wondering. Okay. That really makes me want to Distilled Chaos. Could hit the other Fiendfire, but... that wouldn't be the worst thing, I guess. Warcry Plus, actually. Yeah, we could Secret Technique Warcry. That's a fun thought. But then Ink Bottle is here. Yeah, Secret Tech Warcry Fiendfire, and then I end with Feed in my hand. Does that help me? Not really. Let's Distilled Chaos. That unupgraded Chirgit. Good job, unupgraded Chirgit. Alright, well, Feed is gone. That's okay. Can't get them all, I guess. That's great. That's really great. All we have to do is Fiendfire here, yes? We'll get one energy back, but it won't do anything. Might as well just kill this one, I think. We could also Fiendfire here. Curious. Also, Secret Technique for Bloodletting. Although that would cause Fiendfire to do less. Fun choices. I think I'm just gonna do this. Not overcomplicate it. Evolve. Don't Fiendfire yet. We don't have enough cards in our hands. Just Feel No Pain, Shrug. I want to be able to play whichever of those I'm getting. Actually perfect. We have Immolate in hand when we're not weak. And their Vuln. There's only one turn where that was going to be true. Let's just skip the Warcry. Good. Okay. Nothing else to do here. Just win. Impressed we managed to keep the explosive potion. We score an ornamental fan for a little bit of block if we play three attacks. And we're offered Shrug Plus, or perhaps better yet, Exhume. Get back an exhausted card. With Corruption, yeah, I'll take an Exhume. Definitely. Alright, you two. Show us what you got. Just put this on top. Although maybe I can't feed now, right? Tricky. Question is, how badly do I want to feed on both of them? I think I can do it. Let's try. I'm pretty sure we can do it. With the Dark Embrace in play, specifically. Though that's too much damage now. Hmm. That's not, though. Perfect. Delicious. Let's just evolve here. Be able to use the Juggernaut to get her in feed range. Bash feed. Tasty. There we go. That makes up for some of the feeds we missed previously. Body Slam is here once again. Seeing Red looks pretty good. It's an energy boost and a lot more besides. I could also see Headbutt being good to give us some control over the deck of cards. But I don't feel like I need it. Do I perhaps feel like I needed a second copy of Feel No Pain? Sentinel looks pretty good. Card remove looks pretty good. We could remove Bash. Although having a renewable source of Vulnerable looks pretty good. Have I made a 20 win streak content for every character? We've done reasonable length streaks with every character. The exclamation point, I think PB command, has my longest win streaks with each character. After the mastery challenge is concluded, I do see us going back to win streaking in some fashion. Thought we mastered Trip? We have not managed to do so yet. Trip does seem nice, especially as an AoE Vuln option. I just want the second Feel No Pain. That's what I'm gonna buy. And nothing more. I do feel like we're pretty good against another elite here, so maybe we do want to take one elite. It's not three slavers. Could be either Gremlins or the other one. I'm doing okay on cards. We're in no danger of losing to the boss. So let's take one more elite here. With an event first. Shame. I'll take your Shame Curse for an Eternal Feather, healing us based on the number of cards we have. Shame is one of the unmastered curses, so I'm grabbing it for that reason, primarily. Let's use the Weak Potion. Ouch. I see. I guess immolate Hemokinesis here, activate the Ornamental Fan. Could also go Hemokinesis Fiendfire. I don't want to redraw the immolate or evolve. Immolate Hemo is more damage though. Want to do as much damage as possible to this enemy. This is definitely a fight that needs to end sooner rather than later. Or else. Want to exhume here. Probably Seeing Red, huh? Very probably. So Fiendfire very obviously kills. Feed doesn't. See if we can get back to that feed. Could do Bloodletting Explosive Potion feed, but that seems like a bit of overkill. Well, maybe not. Guess it was the only way to get it. I'll just take the W. We get a Gurria! We can now lift at rest sites to gain strength, which I think is pretty good. And a cultist potion that gives strength per turn. Reckless Charge creates statuses for us, which fuels the Feel No Pain and the Evolve. Or we could add one more shrug here. Range merging accident with the 5 months of support. Heck yeah. Is it ever worth spending a potion to land a feat? It can be, definitely. Sometimes potions end up discarded here. And given that we're guaranteed getting a potion every fight, there's maybe some consideration there. Hollywood with 37 months of support. Thank you. I think I am going to take one Reckless Charge here. But the Shrug It Off is also pretty good. And I'm going to lift. Give me strength. Well, actually, no. Hold on. I'm going to upgrade True Grit and then start lifting. Never again, unupgraded True Grit. You have ruined my feed enough times, aka one time. Since we have White Beast Statue, I really don't see any reason to try to preserve this cultist potion. Let's gain one strength per turn for the boss fight. Seems relatively important, actually. Let's see here. Good. I see that all of my block cards have coagulated together here. Which makes me very glad that I have 74 hit points. I could play Fiendfire for some damage, but that would delete all of these cards, and I really don't want to do that. So we're just going to end the turn. And we're going to put all the other powers in play. Regardless of the cost. Seems fine to me. Ow. Definitely the best turn for Immolate here. Feel free to steal my cards. I don't care. So, can't feed on minions. Fatal card specifies a non-minion enemy. Anything with this skull icon here will not give us max health from the feed. I draw the card immediately as well, huh? Alright, put that dazed on top. This hand we can just Fiendfire. Let's do this first. I think I could feed right now, actually. Let's do that. This activates Ornamental Fan, which activates Juggernaut. But I think it lives on one. Right, let's just double check. 36, 44, leaves 8, we deal 7. Yes, it lives on one. Immolate would deal even more damage. So Immolate would kill instantly. We don't want that. What we want is a way to heal, like a Reaper. Although I don't actually have real strength. We only have strength from the potion that we use there. Could take a third Fiendfire. Or we could take a Berserk to gain Vulnerable and Energy each turn. Honestly, I might take none of the above. Oh, we have Gurria, that's right. But I also have Eternal Feather. I'm skipping these. Ah, there it is. Neko Eye is here, after all. To draw more cards at random cost. Maybe a little iffy with this deck. We have a bunch of zero-cost cards, although many of them are skills, and corruption will override and make the free skills still free. We also upgraded most of the expensive powers, so I'm not actually sure this is good. But if I take Cursed Key for a chance at Shame Mastery, more energy can't hurt either. Certainly it's not the last option, Sozu, which prevents us from picking up new potions. That would be a no-no. Odd placement of elites. As before, we do want a bunch of regular combats. Because of the prayer wheel, which is even more valuable now than before. So let's start with 5 combats in a row. And then maybe we can do 2 elites or something. We'll see. Well, let's just start with 5 combats. Might as well use this. Duck. That feed. It'll happen. Perfect. Some cases not playing Juggernaut deliberately because we want to be able to feed on the creature. Take a flame barrier here. It's a good corruption card. Distilled Chaos is back and better than ever. Dang straight. That's not quite good enough. YOLO. Perfect. Wait, that's not quite perfect. Wait. Now it's perfect. Delicious. More unupgraded Trugrets, more Berserks, nothing we need. The multi-feed? Question mark? Looks like I might have more pressing concerns. All right then. Settles it. Good. Dark Embrace is here. Seems rather important. I'm out of here. A pummel strike and another flame barrier. Sounds good to me. Sounds really good to me. Cry? I don't necessarily want a secret technique anything here. Let's take one. Keep that card around. Already burned through all my cards somehow. That would have been a deep shame. Stop there. Senemy doesn't gain strength over time, so we can usually stop after we've full blocked for a turn. Slowly whittling them down. Juggernaut stuff too. Perfect. Delicious. Upgraded Battle Trance. Upgraded True Grit definitely gets added. Keep the Flex Pot over the Explosive Pot. I think so. Don't know if I actually want the second Battle Trance. I guess I'll take it. Helps us get the powers down initially. And we can burn it with something if we don't actually want it. But yeah, being able to do initial turns like this is very nice. Dark Embrace, though, huh? There you are. Delicious power potion, potentially exceedingly strong. Entrench is curious. Dual wield can do interesting things too, although I'll probably just take the no-brainer shrug it off plus here. These I'll skip. Let's do power potion elixir. I think those are very good potions for this deck. Okay, we have arrived. We're actually at very high HP, so I don't feel the need to visit rest sites at the moment. I guess we could lift there, huh? It's really not where our damage is coming from. Let's fight some elites. I'm not afraid of Reptomancer. Nor Giant Head, really. Nemesis just seems cute. You're cute, I tell you. Cute. Take one. Here we go. Let's do a bunch of damage with Fiendfire. Doesn't seem like that big of a problem. I guess losing the block cards is a slight issue. There we are. Definitely feels a bit different when Dark Embrace is at or near the bottom of the deck. Which is why that's something we got to avoid for the most part. Possibly by acquiring another copy of Dark Embrace. Cryptolo, thanks for 14 months. Heck yeah. Delicious. How many fiend fires does it take to get to the center of the spire? And Heart of Iron, also good with the Juggernaut, too. I think I'll take that over the Power Potion. Yeah, let's keep fighting elites. I feel good. Remove a card. Are we sure about Bash? I guess Hemokinesis or Twin Strike can go. Let's lose Twin Strike. That has been a mediocre card, for sure. Second elite is Reptomancer, who I'm extremely glad to see. Because Gremlin Horn says hello. Assuming I can draw any damage. Trouble. I smell trouble. I guess we just start with a battle trance and see what happens. I see. That's definitely trouble. But my face, though. You mean one Immolate in a 35 card deck isn't reliable? What is this? I, for one, cannot believe it. Skipping out on Juggernaut feels bad. We probably want to Fiendfire for at least two cards. Pace tank it to establish dominance. I think we're going to have to do something to that effect. Not for dominance reasons, though. It's out of simple necessity. Ouch. There's no energy generating card in the draw pile. Let's not second Feel No Pain quite yet. Thank you. I am looking for... Well, actually, this will work well. Deck needs a heat sinks, right? I'll say. Put an end to this sooner rather than later. Beautiful. We got ourselves some bronze scales. How about a second juggernaut? Currently not fighting the awakened one. Let's try it. This is the guaranteed chest. We need the blue key from this chest. We get a clumsy. That is another unmastered curse. And a card that says exhaust on it. That's actually one of the more difficult cards to master. Clumsy. Delicious. No, maybe? Probably not. Yeah, I'm gonna go with no. No, no, no. None of that. You again? I dare say you're rather unwelcome. At least you're not making too much difficulty for us here with this initial turn of yours. I'll take it. This is a bit of a problem. No longer a problem. No, I asked for that. That's fair. That's fair. I did that to myself. Just see if I can... Yeah, okay. All's well, then. Never punished, indeed. How many fire potions do we want? None, I think, is the answer. Still no way to weaken the heart? That's not true. We have Shockwave. Might want to upgrade Shockwave. Toxic Egg, you're a little bit late. Not useless, but mostly late. I think Discovery could be a valuable addition to the deck. See, Prismatic Shard is here, although I'm not seeing what it might actually do for us. Wrong secret. We get very little from the shard. I guess I could take 4 more card rewards if I really wanted to. I don't really want to. Shard is heat sinks. That's, it could be, actually. I think we want to save for our chance at a duplication here. But I will take the discovery. As aforementioned. That and nothing else. That's not the right curse. 7 max health? Ouch. Do it. I will do it. Oops. Still not correct. I can exhume it, sure. We can do that. Cards. Just in time. Perfect. Guess you're gone, Pommel Strike. I'm sorry, but I'm also not sorry. The double jug. It's fine. Why are you still here? Delicious. Question card at the very, very end. How absurd. Do you get a fairy in a bottle? If we would die, heal to 30% of our ginormous max HP. I'll be taking that. And I won't be taking any of the cards. What I will be doing is healing for 21 and then getting the red key with the recall action so that we're ready for our boss gauntlet here. Time Eaters first. Who knows what's next? We would definitely prefer Donu Deka to the Awakened One, but I think we're capable of defeating both of them. Definitely we prefer to just be able to play all the powers and laugh, though. Laugh all the way home. Secret tech here for what? Flame Barrier is pretty good. Shockwave is okay. Let's do Flame Barrier. And then we can delete all of these. Although losing bloodletting hurts a bit. That's fine. delete that. Another evolve. Sure. Since Time Eater does like to add statuses to the deck, double evolve sounds fine by me. Let's see. Ouch. It stings a bit. Plenty of health left, though. And not yet afraid. Play yet. Whoops. Actually, that's fine. Discovery is a good exhume. Definitely not what I was trying to click on, though. Did a double click with my mouse. Oh well, I'm fine with that. I need to know what this draws before I play Juggernaut. Yeah. Definitely want to be able to play Corruption next turn. I'm actually quite glad we're getting debuffed. Let's go, Feel No Pain, Pommel. I wish I could play this Juggernaut as well, but such is the price of dealing in 2-cost cards. Here we go, second Dark Embrace. Heal to half thing. Could start with Fiendfire here. Which damage is that? We would deal 10 times 7 plus 12 times 8. ...166 damage. And then I can do 24, 24, 12, which is 60. That'd be 226. That's not enough damage, so don't do that. Okay, yeah, don't do that. Just don't play any cards. That draw, though. Dang. Oh, the exhaust potion could have gotten us there. Although we're not getting a potion after this fight, so prefer to win without using a potion. Use this to full block. We can buy one, of course. Boss number two is indeed the Awakened One. Okay, we'll have to be a little bit discretionary about how we do this. If you play every single power, then the bird will gain a lot of strength, which makes it pretty tricky for things to end well here. I should really like having the simulate around. Bummer. So if I guess I only save one thing, I save Immolate, huh? Okay. More than willing to use the Elixir Potion in this fight if need be here. Definitely get to play Dark Embrace. There's no question that that must be played. Go bash Immolate? I think so. Kill you as well. And then presumably we delete this Juggernaut. Don't think we play Corruption in this fight. This is the one fight where we don't want to do that. Although it could be difficult to get away with not doing it as well. No. Well, once we get down to a certain subset of cards, this is going to work out really well. Although we'll have to sacrifice some health up front to make it happen. I think we do play Evolve. As aforementioned, we also have to play one of these Feel No Pains. Turn is a multi-hit again. He's gonna make. I'll be keeping that for later. That sounds grand. Definitely wants this Reckless Charge next turn. And Frail's kind of bad, but what can you do? What can you do? Oh goodness, it's a full 14x4, huh? Concerning. Shoot. Already played too many powers. That's what this is telling me. Ominous. Maybe we need to just play everything. Shoot. Hoping I could boil us down to a specific subset of cards that would let us win, but I'm no longer sure that exists. This would be one of those fights to consider save and quitting. This is 56. That is way too much. No way to weaken either. This will be worth it, actually. Okay, let's do this. And we might have to use the Elixir this turn. Let's have a look-see here. Yeah, I'd say so. Should probably also lose the feed. Maybe we need to feed on one of the minions here? Ultimately, we don't need to. Around, it looks like. Okay. We do still want to bash, huh? 6 block per exhausted card. 16 by 4 is 64. So yes, we're going to use the elixir here. That's 36. 28 more block. So yeah, we need to get rid of 4 here. I guess this daze is fine, too. I do have one thing we can exhume. Food for thought. We might use that fairy as well. Use the fairy. Let's go ahead and do it. I was hoping I might be able to get Juggernaut for the second phase, but we're in a desperate enough spot here. I think we should grab something like Shockwave, buy us some time. Bloodletting to Emily. We should probably do that. We need to accelerate this. Draw shrug? No, we don't guarantee draw anything here. Let's just lose the... Yeah, the burn's a good exhaust target. Do I want to get rid of any of these cards? Don't think so. We need all of them. So we might as well play one or two just for the ink bottle here. Got a lot of damage to block this turn. 50 hit it our way. Thankfully we have ways to deal with that. First here. That's fine. Take some tactical damage here. Ah, we're gonna use all of those hit points, don't worry. We got them for a reason. Don't you know? Thank you. Thanks for the statuses, I guess. Get another 12 blocks. We go to 27, currently taking one. Can we do better? Do worse? Doing worse is like doing better. Except it's not helpful. Twenty by three, with the garbage in hand. Here's one of the difficult turns to block. Can we do it? Yes, because we have bloodletting, is the answer. There's the unupgraded shrug. Health left. We're in danger. I think we're done with Bash now. Just based upon what I have seen. Easy. 10 health to spare, no problem. Don't know what y'all were worried about. We're fine. Only took both my potions and all of my health. Two thump, two thump, two thump. A deep pulsing dread can be felt throughout the room. Is this the heart of the spire? The sound of 1,500 people unclenching at the same time. You ready your blade and bonk that heart. That was definitely a little close there. One copy of Disarm would have made such a big difference in that fight. We're almost up to full here. We could rest all the way to full, or I can lift for one strength. That would help the Spire Spear, Spire Shield fight a bit. 9 more hit points is worth it, though, I think. We have no other healing relics, right? That's right. Let's have a schnooze. Mummified Hand, where have you been? Yoink, as they say. Leaves me with enough money for one potion, which is probably going to be the skill potion? Maybe we wanted to consider something like potion offering burning pact instead, but I think Mummy Hand is going to help. Quite a lot. Let's grab a skill pot. This could save us hit points, but this could do even more. This can draw cards, which is pretty dang important. That's a nice looking turn one. Puddle first. Definitely a nice looking turn one. We could exhume Shockwave with Secret Tech or a few other things besides. Alright, and a card got made free. Immolate is free now. That's ridiculous. I'll take a free little no pain. That means I'm going to take B-Trans Plus. Definitely. Vulnerable here or here? Getting a Volve in play would have been nice. Next turn is probably when I'm going to use the skill potion. Ink bottle is also a little tempting here, but we got more cards to play. Let's go spear first, although I might regret it. I'm not going to play this, although it does damage twice. It does do damage twice. Battle Trance. I think we might want a skill potion first. Let's do that. Yeah, exactly. This can draw cards. Very important. Very, very, very important. Juggernaut yet. Of course. Amazing. So I guess we Juggernaut Fiendfire in this direction. This could hurt. A little bit. Still feed on one of them, though. Not that one, though. Apparently not also this one. Back for you in a moment. There we go. Wait, what? Oh, yeah, because two cards exhausted. Oh, that's fine. I miscounted there. That was three. Yeah, three Juggernaut procs, not two. Whoops. And now for the heart. Guess I can't complain that much about turn one Shockwave Juggernaut. The Snecko Oil is pretty valuable. I don't think I use it yet, though. Let's get rid of Hemokinesis. This is an adequate start. This is no longer adequate. Perfect. Do I need that Immolate? I might need that Immolate. Let's keep it. All that block, though, that's really important. That we don't take a huge amount of life loss there. Getting Flame Barrier this turn is pretty sweet as well. We could even play it before playing Corruption if we wanted to. And I think I do want to. Which means we don't get to play Evolve? That's not true. Well, maybe it is true. It is true. Okay. I'll live. Even if Evolve doesn't. Do a lot of damage this turn. Ooh. That damage. Great time to exhume Shockwave if we want the heart to be weak for the next two turns. I think we do. The next four turns. Perfect. And play that. Capped damage this turn. Note that the damage from cards exhausting in my hand with Ethereal actually applies at the beginning of the heart's next invincible. cycle, which is odd. So the bottom deck Warcries. This is nice one cost. This for the damage. Get hacked. You poor thing. GG, Mr. Hart. It's good fighting ya. But now you're gone. Gone to my belly. GG.
If you enjoyed that video, watch this one next, and don't forget to follow on Twitch to watch the content live. Click the link in the description below.